Hi, in this video we are going to talk with you about MIDI track. Nowadays it's not very popular type of track because now everyone just use instrument track, which creates the VST plugin, MIDI editor, and also it produces sound, and you can route this audio somewhere here. It's pretty inconvenient that you have to open mixer to route your audio to some other group, and there is no option in this field. But anyway, nowadays everybody are using instrument tracks, and I will show you use cases for a MIDI track. Now my MIDI output goes to remote SL, and I will pick here not connected. First use case for pure MIDI track is the case when you want to trigger few things with one MIDI controller. So I will create an instrument track with Serum and another instrument track with the Massive. And here in the MIDI track, I don't select anything here. I go to MIDI Sense and I activate it. If you press in this field, you can select effect type, but if you press on not connected, you can select Serum and then activate another output and select Massive. Now you can play few synths simultaneously. So you can use this in purpose of sound design. So when you have some MIDI clip, you can create it once and then everything will play. Another use case for this MIDI synths are, for example, times when you use some effects. For example, LFOTool can be triggered from MIDI input. You can activate it here, and then that means that every time some note hit LFO tool, the sync chain will work. Let me show you. I will route my MIDI to Serum, and also I will route it to LFO tool. Here you can see when I added the plugging, that new MIDI input appeared in the list. So now my MIDI track triggers Serum and also LFOTool, and you don't need to make separate tracks for LFOTool, for Serum, so you can use one MIDI track for both. And I think it's a convenient way of using MIDI tracks.